For much of our lives, we have sat comfortably in our homes in the evenings watching our favorite television shows. We do so solely for the entertainment that they bring us. The furthest thing from our mind is how these shows may influence or impact other things. Nonetheless, there is at least one TV show that we watched back in the 1960s that still leaves its mark on many of the television shows that we watch today. My Three Sons was television's second longest running domestic comedy, with 380 episodes over 12 seasons. The Adventures of Ozzie and Harriet holds the record with 425. It was not the first American television series to feature an all-male household. Bachelor Father, starring John Forsythe in a comical way, and Bonanza on a more serious note, were already portraying households with no mother figure. My Three Sons began and greatly influenced what became a popular movement in sitcom television, that of a widowed parent raising a family. The show's influence was noted by the addition of shows like Family Affair, The Courtship of Eddie's Father, Flipper, and The Nanny and the Professor. Each of these featuring bachelors raising children, either on their own or with the help of someone else within the household. Initially, director Peter Tewksbury thought the premise of the series was rather depressing. However, the creators, Don Federson and George Tibbles, chose to focus on and emphasize the lighthearted consequences of a male-only household. Federson was approached by Chevrolet to develop a TV series that would be representative of America. Because of Fred McMurray's popularity in Hollywood at the time, the show was conceived by Federson himself as a television medium for him. Before McMurray would agree to sign his contract, he decided to spend some time with veteran actor Robert Young of Father Knows Best fame. After listening to Young's complaints about the time-consuming workload associated with a weekly television series, he devised for himself and insisted upon a unique shooting schedule. It was to become known as the McMurray Method. Each season was arranged so that Fred McMurray could film all the scenes during two separate intensive filming blocks for a total of 65 working days. One block was 35 and the second was 30 days, with a 10-week vacation in between. As you might guess, the repercussions of this method were absolutely mind-boggling. Guest stars would often have to return later to finish filming an episode. Co-stars had weekly haircuts to avoid continuity discrepancies. Any unforeseen event, such as a growth spurt or losing teeth, or a guest star's passing, could mean virtually disaster for an episode. Oftentimes, he was actually filmed with an episode script not even being completed. His shoots and monologues were very generalized. The episode, and therefore the remaining script, would then be constructed around those generalizations. Almost needlessly to say, the regular cast and the guest stars and the production crew all felt uncomfortable with this out-of-sequence filming technique, and many called it a nightmare. The second condition that he insisted upon was owning a percentage of the show. He was therefore given the right of approving the actors that would play his sons before they were hired. Veteran actor Stanley Livingston was the first of the sons to be cast. Just 9 years old at the time, he had worked regularly on Ozzie and Harriet from 1958 to 1960. He was hired to play Chip, who was the youngest of the Douglas boys when the series premiered. Ryan O'Neill was considered for the role of Mike, the oldest son. However, McMurray felt that he wasn't really suited for the comedy. O'Neill then recommended Tim Considine for the role, since he had recently worked with Fred on Disney's The Shaggy Dog. Original Mouseketeer Don Grady was cast as Robbie. It's been noted that he not only passed the initial casting lineup, but also Fred noticed how well-behaved he was during the audition process. It was during the 1964-1965 season that Tim Considine began expressing a desire to direct as well, but Fetterson dismissed the idea. The two had a serious argument, which led to a falling out between the two. The character was immediately written out of the show. His last appearance was in season 6, The First Marriage, in which Mike marries his longtime girlfriend Sally, played by Meredith McRae. They move to California, where he works as a teacher. The producers choose a new third son, Ernie, as a replacement. A 3-part episode is created. Chip's best friend Ernie loses his parents. He is adopted by Steve Douglas and becomes the youngest son of the family. By the way, Ernie was played by Barry Livingston. His real-life older brother was Stanley Livingston, who played his older brother Chip in the show. Now, widower Steve Douglas did not raise his sons all on his own. He was initially helped by his father-in-law, Bub O'Casey. He is portrayed by actor William Frawley of I Love Lucy fame. He was replaced in the middle of the 1964-1965 season by William Demarest, who played the role of the brother, Charlie O'Casey. He too moves in to keep house and care for the family in Bub's absence. Approximately 2/3 of the way through the series, there are even more changes within the Douglas household. First, the family moves from fictional Bryant Park to Southern California. Next, gorgeous Tina Cole joins the series as its first female regular. She portrays Katie, the girlfriend and eventually wife of Robbie. The couple charmed television audiences who followed their courtship, marriage, and birth of triplets. Tina remained on the series for 5 seasons until it ended in 1972. In the years prior to portraying Katie, Tina actually appeared in several episodes of the series playing different high school girls. There is nothing that can boost a television series like a wedding. So at the beginning of the 10th season, My Three Sons producers have Steve meet and quickly fall in love with Ernie's new teacher, Barbara Harper. She is an attractive widow with a 5-year-old daughter. Of all the actresses who were considered for the role, B-movie scream queen Beverly Garland had a bullet point on her resume that gave her an edge. She had met McMurray during auditions. She told him that My Three Sons was really her own story. She had married a widower with 2 children and raised them as her own, and was now a grandmother. Doing the research for this video, I learned 2 amazing off-screen relationships surrounding the cast. Both involved Tina Cole. Don Grady almost left the show when Tina Cole was cast as Katie. In an interview, Cole revealed that Grady felt that she just wasn't the type. As it turned out, they eventually fell in love in real life and almost got married not once, but twice. Now, Tina's My Three Sons TV mother-in-law, actress Beverly Garland, who joined the series as Barbara Harper in 1969, became her real-life mother-in-law when Tina married Beverly's son, Fillmore Crank, in 1979. Fillmore and Tina have 3 children together. It seemed as though no one could escape the marriage bug. In the fall of 1970, Chip eloped with his college girlfriend, Polly Williams. She was played by a young actress, Ronnie Troop. She was the daughter and stepdaughter of veteran actors Bobby Troop and Julie London, both starring in the 70s TV drama Emergency. Steve Douglas, Fred McMurray's character, was ranked number 7 in TV Guide's list of the 50 greatest TV dads of all time in 2004. Despite its popularity, My Three Sons never ranked in the top 10. The closest it ever came was in season 2 when it hit number 11 in the Nielsen charts. The show has become one of the biggest success stories in television history, yet it remains somewhat unnoticed today. It's interesting to note, though, any show over the last 60 years that features a single-parent family, adoption as part of the family, or a blended family owes its premise and ideal in one way or another to My Three Sons. Thank you so much for watching while we continue to chase the classics.